Hello world, it's Rahul. Welcome back guys to machine learning tutorial, and today we'll be going to discuss why we need logistic regression, why it is called as logistic regression, and we'll see the mathematics used behind this machine learning algorithm. So guys, logistic regression uses an equation as the representation, very much like linear regression, where input values x are combined linearly using weights or coefficient value to predict an output value y. So guys, key difference from linear regression is that the output value being modeled is a binary value, that is either 0 or 1 rather than a numeric value. So we can say that it's an extension of the linear regression model for classification problems and mostly used for binary classification. So guys, let me take a very simple example for you to let you understand. Let's say at x-axis we have marks. So based on marks, let's categorize data points as fail and pass. That means if marks is greater than 50, then these values will come under pass criteria. And if less than 50, then I'm considering it as fail. So here pass get 1 and fail get 0. Now suppose if I want to classify for future data point, can we use linear regression over here? So let's have a quick recap of linear regression. So guys, linear regression is nothing but to draw a straight line such that the distance between these data points and hyperplane should be minimum, as we have learned earlier. So based on this, let's say we have created a straight line as shown on the screen. Now to make a prediction, we may say that for any given marks x, if f of x gets more than 0.5, we predict that as pass. Otherwise, we predict as fail. So suppose this is the point of our prediction, and if I draw a line from this point to the straight line, then it will come at 0.65, that is more than 0.5, so we can predict it as pass. Looks like this way we could correctly predict every single training set sample. So now question arises, when we are able to solve this problem using linear regression, then what is the need of logistic regression or binary classification? Let's change this task a bit. Now it's clear that all marks larger than certain threshold will be categorized as pass. So let's add another sample with the higher marks highlighted with green point on the screen and try to create best fit line again. Now our hypothesis of h of x greater than 0.5 equal to pass doesn't work here anymore. To keep making correct predictions, we need to change it to h of x greater than 0.2 or something like that. But that's not how the algorithm should work. Suppose in this newly created straight line, if I take 0.5, then it will incorrectly categorize highlighted data points as fail, unless if we don't change the threshold value again. But we can't change the hypothesis each time a new sample arrives. Instead, we should learn it off the training set data, and then using the hypothesis we have learned, make correct predictions for the data we haven't seen before. Guys, just to add one more thing, that both linear regression and logistic regression give you a straight line, but those lines have different meanings. As in linear regression, it extrapolates and gives you values below 0 and above 1, as shown on the screen for some data points. Whereas in logistic regression model, instead of fitting a straight line or hyperplane, uses the logistic function to squeeze the output of a linear equation between 0 and 1. Hope this will make you guys understand why linear regression is not the best fit for these types of problem where we must classify between 0 or 1. So guys, let's start understanding how does logistic regression work. In linear regression, we have modeled the relationship between dependent variable and independent variable with a linear equation, that is y is equal to mx plus b. Here also, we need to find out the linearly separable straight line between two classes, by making use of regression coefficient M and B. But these coefficient differs from the interpretation of coefficient in linear regression, since the outcome in logistic regression is a probability between 0 and 1. Let's quickly understand what I have just said. So, just look into this example where data points are scattered and differentiated by a straight line. So, above this hyperplane, points are considered as class 1, otherwise class 0. Now, let's calculate the summation of distance of these data points with the straight line, and that is 9. Now, suppose we have introduced one outlier, that is nothing but new data point as shown on the screen. Now again, if I add this data point for calculating the summation of distance of data points with the straight line, then we'll have this as 54. That is very high. But according to the theorem we have seen earlier in linear regression session that this distance should be as low as possible. So now for reducing this distance or error, model will try to create new straight line as shown on the screen. And guys, if you can see, you will be able to visualize that this is horrible as it is misclassified most of the data points only due to one introduced outlier in the Cartesian. So for dealing with this problem, we can't go with the approach what we have used in linear regression model for finding the straight line. Though we'll use sigmoid function as its range is from 0 to 1 and this function is capable of dealing with outliers without affecting the straight line. So guys, logistic regression uses sigmoid function to transform linear regression into the logit function. And logit is nothing but the log of odds. And then using the log of odds, it calculates the required probability. So let's understand first what is the sigmoid function and what is the log of odds. So guys, sigmoid function is a mathematical function having a characteristic of S-shaped curve or sigmoid curve with the formula of 1 over 1 plus e to the power minus pi. So sigmoid function gives us the probability of being into class 1 or class 0. So generally, we take the threshold as 0.5 and say that if p is greater than 0.5, then it belongs to class 1. And if p is smaller than 0.5, then it belongs to class 0. However, this is not the fixed threshold. This varies based on the business problem and what threshold value should be. We can decide it with the help of AIC and ROC curves, what we will see in upcoming sessions. So guys, let's talk about log of odds. So the odds ratio is obtained by the probability of an event occurring divided by the probability that it will not occur, and taking the log of odds ratio will give the log of odds. So logistic function or sigmoid function can be transformed into an odds ratio as p over 1 minus p. So guys, let's quickly look into one example. Here I can denote 1 minus p as q for ease of our calculation. Let's say p is the probability of pass and q is the probability of fail, that is 1 minus p. Then if s is given as probability of pass equal to numerator upon numerator plus denominator, and probability of fail q is equal to denominator upon numerator plus denominator as shown on the screen. So let's consider if the odds of pass are 10:4, then what will be the probability of pass? So, probability of pass p is equal to numerator upon numerator plus denominator, that is p is equal to 10 upon 10 plus 4, that is 10 upon 14. So guys, for quoting this odds with sigmoid function, we have linear regression equation as y is equal to mx plus b and sigmoid function as 1 over 1 plus e to the power minus y. Now let's substitute y with its value, that is mx plus b, in equation 1. Here I am assuming m as summation of all independent variables slope value. Now it's look very hard to solve. So let's transform this into some easy to solve equation with the help of odds ratio, that is p over 1 minus p. So guys, let's replace p in odds ratio and we'll get equation 2. Now expand this equation and cancel the terms which are opposite to each other as shown in the equation 3. Now we'll get s as an exponential of beta value as shown in the equation 4. So guys, now we'll take log each side for solving this. And if you can see the screen, log ratio is nothing but the summation of mx plus b. Now question arises, how can we optimize this for further improvement? So guys, just to add one thing, that in logistic regression, we maximize log likelihood instead of least square method of minimizing the error which is used in linear models. So the main reason behind this is that the sum of square error is not convex function. Hence, finding single minima won't be easy. There could be more than one minima. However, log likelihood is a convex function and hence finding optimal parameter is easier. Optimal could be max or minimum. And here in case of log likelihood, it is maximum. So guys, let's quickly find out the regression coefficient using log likelihood. As we already know that probability of yi equal to 1 given xi for m will be h of xi, and probability of yi equal to 0 given xi for m will be 1 minus h of xi. So by using this knowledge, we can interpret that the probability of yi given xi for m will be h of xi power yi into 1 minus h of xi power 1 minus yi. So if I put yi as 0, then h of xi term will become 1 and will have 1 minus h of xi only. And if I put yi as 1, then 1 minus h of xi will become 1 and will have h of xi term only with us. So guys, now let's find out the log likelihood of this equation by putting log both sides. So guys, before moving ahead, let me give you basic intuition about log and exponential derivations and their properties. So derivative of log x will be 1 over x. Then derivative of x power n will be n into x power n minus 1, what we have seen during linear regression session. Then derivation of e to the power x will be e to the power x only. Then derivative of a to the power x will be a to the power x log a. Now let's find out if we have log of ax squared plus e to the power 2x, then derivative of this will be 1 over ax squared plus e to the power 2x, as we have seen in first equation for derivation of log x. Then by applying chain rule, we'll find derivation of ax squared plus e to the power 2x. So we'll get 2ax plus 2e to the power 2x over ax squared plus e to the power 2x. So guys, before wrapping up this, let me tell you one property of log which we'll going to use later on, and that is log of multiplication will become log of addition as shown in the equation log xy is equal to log x plus log y. Okay, so by applying log x into y, we have an equation as summation of yi log h of xi plus 1 minus yi log of 1 minus h of xi. Now we'll find derivative for each term to get the final m value for drawing the straight line. So here in first term, we'll apply derivative of log of x, that is 1 over x. So according to that, we'll have yi over h of xi and derivative of h of xi by using chain rule. So if we look into second term, then again we'll apply log derivation and get 1 minus yi over 1 minus h of xi and derivation of x component, that is 1 minus h of xi. Now let's take h of xi as common for both terms, as derivation of constant is nothing. So we'll get minus h of xi only while we derivate the 1 minus h of xi in second term. So guys, we don't know derivative of h of xi till now. So let's calculate derivative of h of xi separately first. As we know that h of xi is nothing but the sigmoid value, that is 1 over 1 plus e to the power minus x. So we'll apply power rule and chain rule to this. Guys, I have already taught how to derive power rule and chain rule in linear regression session. So if you don't know about that, then I'll suggest you to first have a look into that. I'll attach the link to this video. Okay, so by applying power rule and chain rule, we'll get it as square of 1 plus e to the power minus x into e to the power minus x. Now let's take square of 1 plus e to the power minus x into denominator and separate into subtraction of two fractions by adding and subtracting 1. And now we have 1 over 1 plus e to the power minus x as common. So guys, we can interpret it as h of x into 1 minus h of x by using our prior knowledge. So guys, now we have derivation of h of xi term with us. We'll simply substitute the resultant in equation and expand that so that we will get the new equation as shown on the screen. By just cancelling out the terms, we will have our m value as yi minus h of xi into xi. So we can directly put this value to m, where m is equal to m minus learning rate into derivated value of m, what we have find just now for generating best fit line between two classes. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.